Namaste everybody, this is Umesh Kirat from the Department of Biomedical Engineering, Nepal Medicity, and today we are going to make a short video which is intended to take a look into how to set up and operate an infusion pump. So the infusion pump that we are going to take a look today is the one from Fresenius Kabi, and it's called the Agilia VP. It is quite different from its elder sibling, the Optima VS, which we are used to seeing and operating. So one of the main points to notice is the compatibility of the infusion lines. Unlike other infusion pumps which accept any infusion lines, JMS and B Brown interfix to be precise which are being used, this pump only accepts a single dedicated line, which is the volumet line. So we'll take a look at the infusion line. So this line is called the volumet line, and this is the only compatible infusion line which is going to work on this infusion pump. So please make sure that you remember to indent this particular IV set when using this particular infusion pump. So first things first, we will take a look into the physical aspects of the infusion pump. So if we start from the front, we can see the display and an array of buttons and LEDs. On the leftmost part is the power button, which is obviously going to turn on and turn off the equipment. And towards the right, you can see a green button which is used for starting an infusion or validating any changes. Similarly, the stop button will stop the infusion, the C button will clear any changes, and the navigation buttons, the four buttons in the middle, they will be used to change any values or navigate through the menu. There is a bolus button which is going to be used for providing any boluses or priming the infusion set. The other buttons you can see are the menu, pressure, and the one to silence any alarms. The other thing to notice is that there is an LED which when the equipment is powered on will show a yellow light, and also there is an array of LED which is going to tell you if the infusion is under progress. Also, it will tell you if there are any alarms. So the other part of the infusion pump is the door, which can be opened and closed by pulling and pushing this lever. So to open the door, you pull in the lever and you pull in the door, and to close, you push the door and then you push the lever. So once you open the door, you can see notches where you can put in the IV set. So now we'll be taking a look into the back of the infusion pump. So when you turn it back, there are a couple of things you can see, among which is the clamp. So this is the clamp which can be used to clamp in the equipment into the IV pole. And the other notable thing to notice is the inlet for a power socket. So before operating this equipment, the first thing that we have to notice is that we will have to clamp this to the IV pole. So how do we do that? I will make a small demonstration. So first we place it towards the IV pole, loosen up the screw, and then once it's placed in the IV pole, we will tighten the screw. We will tighten it as long as the equipment is not loose anymore and it's fixed to its place. So after that, we should always remember that we should always operate this equipment with its power on. So we will put in the inlet to the power, and we can hear a sound. And if we turn it on, so like we previously said, there's a light coming in. So it's green actually. I thought it would be yellow, but it's green. So this is the infusion line that is going to be compatible with our infusion pump. I'll show you again, it's the volumet line, so that you don't get confused in the future. So we will open it up and then remove it. So like any normal IV set, you can see all the common things, the roller clamp. And the other thing that you can see which is different from other infusion set is the availability of this part here, which is quite stretchable, and also there's this protruding part from the infusion set, which is going to be the key element for the infusion pump. So now we're going to show you all how to fix the IV set in the infusion pump. So we will first start with the infusion pump, where you can see that there is a blue part protruding out of the infusion pump, and there is a circular part, a blue circular part over here, and then there is a green part on the other side of the infusion set, and it stretches as well. So one thing to notice is that when the equipment is being delivered power, every time you open the door, the equipment turns itself on. So we'll do that. We'll open the door and the equipment turn itself on. Now we will have to place in the infusion set into the infusion pump. So the as you can see on the infusion pump as well, there is a blue part here, it's a notch, silence the alarm, and there is a green part on the other side of the pump, and similarly you can see that this is blue color coded and the other part is green color coded. So we will place the blue part on the blue notch in this way, so that the IV line will also fall on the notch here, which is for the IV line. So we'll place it in so it fits perfectly. I'll show you again. So it fits perfectly, and then the green part, you'll have to pull it a bit and then place it. Let's show it again. We'll pull in the green part and then place it in here, and then we will close the door. You can see that there is only one profile, which is the basic profile, so there is no need to do any changes. We'll close in the door, and then we will insert any fluid that we will be delivering to the patient. So for demonstration purpose, we are using normal saline and we'll be fixing it in the infusion set. So there is only one profile, so we'll click OK. So now you can see that it will ask you if you want to change the programming mode. So there are two programming modes. If you press the C button, you can see that there is a flow rate mode and a dose rate mode. So we will be continuing with the flow rate mode, which is ml per hour. So we will press OK on that. So now you can see there's an alarm for air bubble, since there are air bubbles in the infusion set. So what we are going to do is that we will purge the infusion set. So how do we do that? We will use the bolus key. So I'll press the bolus key once. It will instruct us to disconnect patient during priming. So what we are going to do, the patient is disconnected, we'll press the OK button. So it says that press and hold the bolus button to prime. So what we'll do, we will press the bolus button, and you can see the drips here, and also the set is being primed. So we will prime it until there are no air bubbles in the IV set. So once it is done, we will release the bolus button, and then it goes for the OCS test. So what we have to, it gives you the instruction here. So it tells us to open and close the door for OCS test. So what we'll do, we'll pull in the lever and pull the door to open the door, and then it says to close the door. So we'll push the door and push the clamp as well. So the OCS test now starts. So the OCS test has passed. Now the key things to remember here is that we have to compulsorily place in the amount of volume that we are planning to infuse. So that is going to be the total volume that we will be infusing. If we do not know, if we are not certain about how much volume we will be using, we can just put it to the maximum. So we will just give a demonstration. So if we press these two buttons, it will go to the highest value. So if you don't know exactly how much volume you will be delivering to the patient, you just press the two buttons. So now let us suppose that we will be delivering 500 ml of fluid to the patient. So now the volume to be infused is entered. Now we press OK. Then we have to set in the flow rate. Let's suppose that we will be delivering the flow rate to, for example, I will set in 50. So 50 ml per hour, and then we will press the OK button. Once we press the OK button, it will prompt us to press the green button to start the infusion. So we will press start. After that, you can see the LEDs moving forward. So this is going, this is indicating that the infusion is taking place. There is also symbol here, signal here, that tells us that the infusion is moving forward. So the other point is that we might have certain conditions where we have to provide bolus to the patient. So how do we do that? We will press the bolus button once. The bolus menu will pop up. It tells us that it will deliver bolus in 1500 ml per hour. So what we do, we press the bolus button with the green button, and then it tells us to press and hold the bolus button, which we will do. So the bolus is being delivered. After every 1 ml of bolus, there is a beep sound, and when we feel that we have delivered enough bolus, we will leave the bolus button, and then the bolus will stop. And the same infusion rate which was previously going to the patient will resume. So after we have infused the desired amount of fluid to the patient, we will stop the infusion. So to do that, we will press the stop button, and to turn on the equipment, we will continuously press the on off button for a couple of seconds until the equipment is turned off.